With the emergence of the likes of Elton Jantjies, Pat Lambie, Johan Goossen, South Africa is blessed with depth at fly-off like we haven't had in many years. Is that an invigorating challenge for you? Because effectively, those guys are all gunning for your position.
Yeah, definitely. Don't want a guy just coming in and take over your position. I think he must still work at it, and I'm not just going to give it to them. That's why I'm going on the practice field and work even harder and look at my videos and see where I did wrong or where I can do better, and just to improve my game every day. Competition is always good for a side and for a player, just to keep yourself on your toes as well. You just don't want to sit there and know it's your number 10 jersey, you're going to keep it for another 5 or 6 years.
Yeah.
So you're not just going to walk into the side.
Outside of Super Rugby, which flowers in the game have impressed you?
Yeah, every weekend there's a guy coming through, a new young guy. In the overseas, like Ireland and England, all those flowers there as well as Saxton and all those guys are doing quite well there. The Carter coming back for the Crusaders now is always... Been one of the world's best. That's what you want to do in rugby, to play against all those big guns and measure yourself.
There's been a rise of a number of skillful backline players like we haven't had in many years. Juan de Jong, Johan Sadi, Francois Venter, the list can go on. There's just an excitement when you think about a potential Springbok backline.
I think there's a excitement around the whole South Africa. Same here at the Bulls as well. If you're on side there, like you said, in front of Venter, Wynand Olivier, guys who spread the ball a bit and we just want to run, don't just want to get the ball under the arm and go over guys. So I think that's an exciting thing for us here at the Bulls and at the Springboks. Like you said, the young and all those guys are there. It's not just going to be a run over game. It's going to be more like the guys want the ball in their hands and take the guys on.
Do you think that's a coaching issue, or are there deeper reasons and sort of more complex reasons for that?
Yeah, I think that's definitely a coaching thing. I think we're sometimes too scared to make mistakes and too scared the next day in the newspaper you're going to be the guy who's throwing the ball away. Since you were a little boy, you have to keep the ball, place the ball nicely. So yeah, I think we can maybe look at that to change it a bit.